Audio test. There we go. And quickly. Alright, where am I going?
Please see to it that Godwin gets home soon and safe.
I'm not going very far at all. Right back here. Wait, what? I'll go to the top of the statue. I'll come back to her since it's on the way.
Quit following me.
That means the rest of them probably haven't reset. Likely have not.
Yes!
Solidify!
Our bond is strong!
The wind rises. Following me.
Onwards.
Squall and fury.
Gather. solidified.
Oh, there it goes.
Stabilize!
Astra Ab- I am sorry.
Oh, that's right. I gotta do the other one. Duh. Forgot about it.
Too slow.
Getting a few more hiccups than this time compared to last.
Ad Astra. Thank you for comp- Ad Astra.
Following me.
Gather.
The bond is strong.
Go! Squall and Fury.
Next. I know it's not the most efficient use of resin, but I really want to level my characters up. So if it costs me a little time to do that, I can always use resin for later on for other things. Damn it.
The wind rises.
Ooh, rain. That's gonna make for an interesting one.
Solidify.
Get with me.
Okay, make it easier.
Swarm and Fury.
Solidify.
The bond is strong.
The wind rises.
Our bond is strong.
The wind rises.
Solidify.
Wretched vermin! You want to use my hat as an...
This realm is... If you ever have any...
even though it's already maxed out. There was something I was about to do. What was it?
There's no need to exchange pleasantries. It's rather pathetic to force a conversation just to occupy.
Be early. Pretty late for me, but early for them. What are we up to? 145? Curiosity? Would it be able to actually level it all the way? Dang. Basically, I need about 150 for 10 levels from 80 to 90. Plus. Wait, how much? Damn, almost 600,000 for each character. That's a lot. But that is not a right now project, that is a future project. Alright. Drum roll. Got it. Boom! Finally! Yeah. About time. Alright, so that means... Nope. Nope, nope, nope. I need 14. Nope. All right. I don't recall. All right, what weapon was I planning to use for her? One with a lot of energy recharge. No, I'm not going to use that many. I did not mean to do that. Since all of her stuff is based on HP, I need to focus on HP. Too bad they're junk. Thank you. already have one. Excuse me. Energy recharged. I mean, it's only temporary anyways until I can get a better set. I think I'll go with that. Not the greatest in the world, but it'll do now. But what other sets were? This is the one. Thank you. I'll deal with it.
My line of work, combat skills are... Sometimes you have to strike. Finding the truth might sound simple, but it takes perseverance to stick.
I thought I'd gathered enough of those. I'll have to make sure I unlock more of them. I got plenty of everything else though. Well, just about. Energy recharge is pretty damn high.
It's time to pull the trigger.
Hmm.
What they say is true.
Let's see. What character would be best? Well, let's try it out. Yay, new character.
Thank you.
Which one do I want to use? Too bad, that's a PlayStation only. Sucks. It's a really cool one. Where are we? What am I forgetting? I just feel like I'm forgetting something. Hey, got some distance.
Are you already finished cooking? Mmm, smells delectable. I'm truly thankful whenever I can enjoy a proper meal like this. Cooking really isn't my forte.
Hmm.
Box that Tainari gave us since we already watched it. Oh, it smells amazing! And the box is a nice touch, too! Let's go serve this up and start eating with Hypatia!
Are you already finished cooking? Mmm, smells delectable. I'm truly thankful. Even though everything you mentioned was in Tainari's letter, it's still hard to believe you were able to connect with Ermin's soul. Immediately after smelling Spiritborn Eel for the first time. It took me nearly 3 years before I could do so. And everyone at the academia even lauded me as a genius. You should know that some researchers spent their entire lives without ever successfully connecting with Ermin's soul as you have.
So why does this incense allow people to connect to Ermin's soul?
The ingredients used to make Spiritborn Eel primarily consist of plants created by Greater Lord Rukadevata. These special ingredients are conducive to heightening our senses to the Dendro Archon's power. Since the root of the Dendro Archon's power lies within Ermin's soul, we can occasionally tap into her powers to peer into the depths of the earth. Naturally. Anyone who can establish a connection with Irmasol in their first ever attempt must be a person of great understanding.
Hmm. Makes sense. But Paimon's got a question. Why was he sensitive to the smell of those plants for such a long time?
That was primarily due to his body's unique constitution. Stimulated by the incense, he could perceive the Dendru Archon's power and experience the sensory overload, hence the adverse reactions. Taking in any scent similar to the ingredients of Spiritborn Ale would cause adverse effects. Not to worry, though. It appears you've already fully recovered. Technically, your body should still be sensitive to the powers of the Dendro Archon, but unless you're using intentional meditation techniques, the scent of Spiritborn Ale should no longer trigger such reactions.
Whew. Well, that's a relief.
I must admit, I am quite envious of your abilities. Even if it meant suffering from pounding headaches for the rest of my life, I'd consider it worthwhile so long as I could connect with Irmasol at will.
Whoa! You're really serious about this whole thing, aren't you?
I am a researcher, after all. As a member of the Ritawis Darshan at the Academia, my main area of research is the stars and their connection to the fate of living beings. But there is still so much we don't know, especially regarding the mysteries that lie in the starry skies. Which is why I must turn to the all-knowing Irmasol for answers. If only my perception wasn't so limited! Unfortunately, I cannot guarantee that my every attempt to attune with Irmasol will be successful, or that doing so will leave my consciousness intact. I am currently in the stage of training known as Satyavada Life. Many researchers in Sumeru have lost their minds while seeking to attune with Irmasol during this stage. Sages have said that Irmasol contains divine knowledge, and touching such knowledge without the proper preparations and abilities will only lead to one's mind caving in on itself. That's why we meditate alone. We need to ensure that our minds will be calm, while minimizing the possibility of involving anyone else.
Whoa. So knowledge from Irmasol could be super dangerous. Don't you ever feel afraid of the risk, Capasia?
Of course I do. Especially during nights that are pitch black with no moonlight, and dead silent without even the sound of insects. However, I've been feeling better as of late. I don't get as scared anymore knowing that I have a little neighbor living nearby. I believe that being able to see them is a sort of blessing from the Dendro Archon. But what's strangest of all is that they're clearly an envoy of the God of Wisdom herself. And they have the curious power to make people dream.
What's so strange about that? It doesn't sound so out of place for a divine being, does it?
Well, it's strange because nearly nobody in Sumeru can ever dream.
Huh. Is that true?
Yes. Well, to an extent. Only children can dream in Sumeru. Adults, however, never do. The sages say that wisdom implies rationality, but that which occurs in dreams is often neither rational nor logical.
Hmm.
Yes. If one struggles with anxieties, those emotions could influence their dreams. The fact that the people of Sumeru do not have dreams is seen as a blessing by the sages. They believe that Greater Lord Rukadevata, the God of Wisdom, is keeping us away from the foolish delusions you encounter in your sleep. I was born into a family of scholars in Sumeru City. Ever since I was a child, my parents would always tell me that I'll know I've grown up once I stop dreaming. I studied hard, enrolled as a student in the academia, and went on to become a researcher. Sure enough, I never dreamed again. But then, on the day I scared the little Aranara, I suddenly saw a dream again. It was incredible. Though I don't exactly remember what I saw, I clearly recall the feeling. I suddenly felt like I was a child again. Back then, I was foolish and ignorant as any youth would be, but I was free of fear. Maybe dreaming isn't as bad as we've made it out to be. Just be sure not to speak of this if you travel to Sumeru City. They'll look at you as if you've lost your mind.
So, do you have any thoughts about the things he saw when he connected with Ermansoul?
Sorry. I'm afraid I don't have any answers as of now. All I can say is that what you saw is a memory contained within Ermansoul itself. World, forget me. What could that possibly mean? If only I could ascend past Satyavada life and begin Paripurna life, I might have some more answers for you. If you two are ever in the area again, please be sure to come and see me. There's no need to be thanking me. You two are my saviors. Besides, I'm already looking forward to tasting some more of your cooking.
Now that we know Hypatia is all right and had the chance to ask her some questions, Paimon thinks it's about time to head back to Gandharvaville.
Heading out, I see. If there's anything else, even though that little neighbor of mine was able to the end of your dream seemed quite not to worry, though. As someone from Sumeru who cannot dream, I needn't ever worry about nightmares. But lately, I've started to feel that I'm somehow missing something without dreams. It's a little hard to explain. Heading out, I see. If there's anything else you'd ever like to ask, Sumeru researchers use Spiritborn Ale to assist them in connecting with Ermansoul to extract knowledge from it. Though the process can be risky, we believe that the knowledge gained is worth it. Unfortunately, I cannot help you understand your dream, at least not yet. I'm still learning how to attune to the depths of Ermansoul myself. I hope that I'll be able to ascend past Satyavada life and gain deeper insights. Heading out, I see? If there's anything else you'd ever like to ask about, you know where to find me. I've heard local children here in the rainforest speaking of fairy-like creatures. But I'm from Sumeru City, and have never heard of such things when I was a child. Perhaps this is because I had a very strict upbringing. My parents would seldom allow me to play with other children. I doubt they'd ever believe me if I told them about my little neighbor out here. And speaking of my little neighbor, I think they can somehow sense when Tainari is coming to visit me. I've noticed on several occasions that as they're playing under the trees, they'll suddenly tense up and scamper away for no apparent reason. Shortly after they do this, Tainari always shows up here. Perhaps I should ask Tainari about this the next time I see him. Heading out, I see? If there's anything else you'd ever like to ask about, you know where to find me. Take care.
Alright.
Do remember to come visit anytime you're in the area.
I think I've got it figured out what I was gonna do. But I'm not gonna do it today. There it is. That's a good enough stopping point for now. I'll tinker with it more tomorrow. Especially with the new party build. Instant. Nice. Well, until the next one, I guess. Good spot to stop. Anyways, I'm out.